10 scorer all time in this league is iconic. And the fact that we've been able to share that with him has been special for all of us. And it's the only Trailblazer name on that backboard right there. So thank you to Melo.
Stop the video. You can clearly see the happiness and joy of Carmelo Anthony and his Portland Trailblazer teammates in this frame. Carmelo Anthony just became a top 10 scorer in the NBA, one of the most impressive feats to ever be accomplished, solidifying himself as an NBA legend. But what if I told you almost 3 years ago, no one would have expected this outcome or even seen Carmelo Anthony in the NBA. 3 years ago, the NBA universe deemed that this was the end of Carmelo Anthony's career and that it was time to move on. Nobody wanted an old, unathletic, selfish, egotistical, ISO scorer in this new generation. Well, the league was wrong, and Carmelo Anthony, with his last opportunity to play in the NBA, has proven every single media critic wrong, in that he has a place in the league and he's one of the best offensive talents we've ever seen. You want to see some low post action? Melo got you. You like to see some of the best footwork in the entire game? Melo has that in his duffy bag as well, don't worry. And I know we love to see someone take over the entire fourth quarter and go on a scoring eruption. You know exactly who I'm talking about. But this isn't new. Melo has been showing us since his college days that he's him. NCAA champion at Syracuse in 2003 put the world on notice that a kid born in Brooklyn, New York was next up. And ever since Melo was drafted third overall in the 2003 NBA draft, he has lived up to the expectations critics set for him. In his 18-year career, Carmelo averages 23 points per game with 6.3 rebounds, shooting nearly 45% from the field and 35% from three. To play over 18 seasons in the NBA and still average a great amount of points throughout that stretch is very impressive. And when you include the longevity of Carmelo's career, Carmelo sits among elite company of NBA legends that have played over 18 seasons and average over 23 points per game. Players that are included in the statistic are LeBron James, Karl Malone, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, and Shaquille O'Neal. Most of these guys I just mentioned operated close to the basket, so it goes to show that Carmelo had a wide range of moves in his offensive game that he could utilize. You could argue that from 2009 to 2014, Carmelo might have been the best offensive talent in the NBA. And it wasn't outlandish to hear this from every sports outlet in the world covering the NBA. Folks knew how scary Carmelo Anthony could be if he started cooking on the offensive side of the ball. We can't forget the night he torched the Charlotte Bobcats in Madison Square Garden and went out for 62 points and a victory in 2014. Carmelo did it all that night, becoming one out of 30 players to ever score over 60 points. And this is coming off his scoring championship that he won in 2013. I can go back to the Denver Nuggets days of Carmelo, giving his peers the business. Clutch bucket? Doesn't matter. Melo will get it done. What about...
Rebound Millsap with Gallo. Pass.
It was at this moment that he knew. He f***ed up.
Yeah, opening night, when he let Paul Millsap know not to stand under the rim. But I think these next two clips can tell the story of who Carmelo really is.
Knicks down three. Should the Bulls foul? No. Anthony for three. Bang! That one goes down and the game is tied.
You want to see me do it again?
In the hands of Anthony. Anthony for three. Puts it in! Knicks by one with 8.2 remaining.
The Garden was electric. It was insanity. But when you're an all-time great, we should have expected that. The biggest knock on Melo is the fact that he'll probably never win a championship. And yeah, championships are important, but I still don't think we should use that to diminish all that Carmelo has accomplished. He's won on the collegiate level, performed to the highest standard on the professional level, and he's played some of the world's best players when you look at his Olympic career. All-time leader in points and rebounds for the US Olympic team, selected to the 2004, 2008, 2012, and 2016 Olympic basketball teams, and has the most Olympic gold medals by any athlete in the sport of basketball with 3 medals. 10-time All-Star, 6-time All-NBA, scoring champ, NCAA champ, and a legacy that will forever be remembered. Don't get caught up in the aura of the Larry O'Brien trophy that it blocks your vision of the beauty of the game. Hold on, that was kind of fire. Wait a minute. Now, it wouldn't be fair to not highlight the last few seasons Melo had to endure after he left the New York Knicks in 2017. After many talks with management, Melo was traded to the Oklahoma City Thunder to play with the reigning MVP Russell Westbrook and newly added All-Star Paul George, a better situation than what he was once in New York. Expected, Carmelo averaged a career low in points, and after an underwhelming first-round playoff series loss to the Utah Jazz, OKC traded Carmelo Anthony to the Atlanta Hawks to save money and gaining quality piece instead of Carmelo Anthony. Carmelo was bought out and became a free agent. In the 2018 offseason, the Houston Rockets sought out after Carmelo Anthony after their heartbreaking Game 7 loss in the 2018 Western Conference Finals, and believed that CP3 and James Harden, with the addition of Carmelo Anthony, could be a lethal offensive trio, spearheaded by Mike D'Antoni, Carmelo Anthony's former coach in New York. In that season, in a game against the Brooklyn Nets, Carmelo went off for 28 points in a win, and it looked like Carmelo finally found a home, until the Rockets shut him down after only 10 games, stating Carmelo had done everything right, he was just a bad fit. Carmelo didn't play another game until he was traded to the Chicago Bulls late in January of 2019, who waived him a week later. If you follow the NBA, you know the slander Melo received, and you know how many people in the NBA media believe he should retire. Mind you, this is a guy who still had so much left in the tank, but just needed the right opportunity to showcase it. But no one believed in him. When you look at his peers, D. Wade had just had a farewell tour. LeBron was still going strong and cementing himself to be one of the best players that ever played a game of basketball. And CP3 was still an elite level point guard in the NBA. The embarrassment was so bad, Carmelo recently came out and stated how it was hard for him to go to his own son's basketball AAU games because the game he loved was taken from him. It's tough. Until the Portland Trailblazers made a call and took a chance on Melo that they wouldn't regret. Signing Melo at the start of the 2019 NBA season, Melo would prove his worth to the team, accepting his role, providing scoring and rebounding, and even won the Western Conference Player of the Week award in that same month of November. The Blazers made his contract fully guaranteed in December, and Carmelo was finally back in the NBA, helping the Blazers get into the playoffs, only emphasized how important Melo was and how different of a player he was now. It earned him another one-year contract with the Trailblazers for this current season. And in this season right now, Carmelo is shooting a career high in three-point percentage since 2010, at 41.3%, a career high in free throw percentage, and has his highest effective field goal percentage in his entire career, all while the Blazers are set to clinch a spot in the playoffs. And on May 3rd, 2021, 907 days since he was shut down by the Houston Rockets, Carmelo Anthony became the 10th highest scorer in NBA history. An accomplishment that seemed out of reach became a reality. I've never been the biggest Carmelo fan, never had a poster of him in my room, but to witness his career from the very start and see the ups and downs, and finally seeing him receive his flowers, is always good to see. It just proves that if you still got it, you can produce in the NBA. After the season, Carmelo will be a free agent, so we don't know what will happen to his career. He may retire. But one thing can be said, Carmelo is one of the best offensive talents we've ever seen in this game, and we've been lucky to see him perform over the past 18 years. If you enjoyed the video, I urge you to please subscribe. I post content on this channel frequently, and I'm sure you'll find something you'll enjoy. Leave a like and comment how you view Carmelo Anthony's career. I'll leave you with what Carmelo said himself, but until next time, stay on beat.
A couple years ago, I didn't think I was gonna be in this moment right now. I was out the league for whatever reason. I'm back, I persevered, I stayed strong, stayed true to myself, and now I'm here in the top 10, so